I am highly elated to come to you once again to continue with our series, Smiling at the Storm, Part 2, which is entitled, The Value of Crisis. Shall we pray? Our most gracious and everlasting Father, we thank you so much for granting us another opportunity to listen to your word. Come and speak to us, for we have prayed in Jesus' name. Amen. A crisis is defined as a time of intense difficulty or danger. Value, as a noun, is defined as the importance, worth, or usefulness of something. Putting them together, the value of crisis refers to the worth or the usefulness of times of intense difficulties. These times of intense difficulties could be social, medical, could be mental, could be spiritual. The question we want to answer is there any worth in crisis? Of course, crisis brings pain, it brings sorrow, it brings tears, it even brings death. But if we are able to deal with crisis well, we will know that they are worthwhile. Before a bar of gold can glitter in its dazzling state, it will have to go through a crisis of purification through fire. In the same way, clothing materials go through crisis under the scissors of fashion designers before they are fashioned into an adorable cloth. Friends, trees also go through the crisis of pruning before they can grow and bear fruit for a bumper harvest. And Jesus tells us in John chapter 15 verse 2, every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Christians also bear fruit after going through a spiritual crisis of pruning, purification, and a cut through. So the reason why you may be suffering, you may be going through trials and tribulation, is that God is shaping you. God is pruning you so you can bear fruit. The pruning process is not a pleasant situation, but we need it for fruit bearing. When you go through a crisis, we should not only see the negative side of it, we should consider its value. Ellen White tells us in her book, Thought on the Mount of Blessing, the trials of life are God's workmen to remove the impurities and roughness from our character. They are hewing, squaring, and chiseling. They are burnishing and polishing. It's a painful process. It is hard to be pressed down to the grinding wheel. She continues, but the stone is brought forth prepared to fill its place in the heavenly temple. Upon no useless material does the master bestow such careful feather work. Only his precious stones are polished after the similitude of a palace. My brother, my sister, I want to tell you that crises are blessings in disguise. Why am I saying that? Let me share to you a story. A king had a male servant who, in all circumstances, always said to him, my king, do not be discouraged. Everything God does is perfect. There are no mistakes. One day they went hunting, and a wild animal attacked the king. The servant managed to kill the animal, but couldn't prevent his majesty from losing a finger. Furious and without showing gratitude, the king said, If God was good, I would not have been attacked and lost one finger. The servant replied, despite all these things, I can only tell you that God is good, and everything he does is perfect, he is never wrong. Outraged by the response, the king ordered the arrest of his servant. While being taken to prison, he told the king again, God is good and perfect. On another day, the king left alone for another hunt and was captured by savages who used human beings for sacrifice. On the altar, the savages found out that the king didn't have one finger in place. He was released because he was considered not complete to be offered to the gods. On his return to the palace, he ordered the release of his servant and said, my friend, God was really good to me. I was almost killed, but for a lack of a single finger, I was let go. But I have a question. If God is so good, why did he allow me to put you in prison? His servant replied, my king, if I had not been put in prison, I would have gone with you and would have been sacrificed because I have no missing finger. Indeed, everything God does is perfect. He is never wrong. No wonder Paul tells us in Romans chapter 8 verse 28, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. Paul says we know because he himself has gone through similar experiences. He knows that everything that we go through works for our good as Christians. So don't be discouraged. Don't be perturbed by your current situation. Don't let your crisis crush you, but let them be springboards for achieving greater heights, even the heavenly kingdom. Some of us would not have prayed, fasted, studied the Bible, and sang sacred songs as we do now, if not for the crisis we are experiencing. We enjoy the testimonies of experienced people because they have been through countless crises and have emerged victorious. The saints in heaven will be people who have gone through a great crisis. Listen to John the Revelator in Revelation chapter 7 verse 14. These are the ones who come out of the great tribulation and washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. So my dear friend, God wants you to appreciate whatever experiences you are going through. He is using them to shape you for a better future. May the Lord strengthen you, and may you be steadfast under his mighty hand. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you so much for speaking to our heart. Sometimes we find it difficult to bear our pains. So I want to plead with you to grant us strength to go through whatever crisis we may be going through. We thank you so much for an answered prayer, for we have prayed in Jesus' name. Amen.